closing of stomach. Okay, here we are going to study a simple mechanism why the stomata opens during day and why it closes during night. So exactly what happens here. So during daytime, endoosmosis takes place. Endoosmosis means here in the subsidiary cells, maximum amount of water is there as compared to guard cells. During daytime, maximum water is present in the subsidiary cells and less amount of water is present in the guard cells. So naturally, what is osmosis? Water always moves from the region of higher concentration to the region of lower concentration. So during day, water takes entry inside the guard cells. Because of the endoosmosis or because of the entry of water inside the guard cells swell. Because of the swelling, this wall, which is elastic in nature, it gets stretched. It creates pressure on the inner wall. Actually, it is very hard, but it creates pressure on the inner wall also, and inner wall also fold apart from each other. These outer wall, because of endoosmosis, these outer wall of guard cells get stretched. Okay, and this creates pressure on the inner wall also, and because of this pressure, the inner wall also get pulled apart from each other. And it results into the opening of stomata. Okay, just reverse case during night. During night, what happens? Now the concentration of water in the guard cells is more as compared to subsidiary cells. So what happens? Exosmosis takes place and the water moves out from guard cells to the subsidiary cells. As the water moves outside, as the exosmosis takes place, this guard cells becomes flaccid, which is turgid during daytime, but now during the night it becomes flaccid. So because of this flaccidity, this guard cells get to shrink and the inner wall come close to each other and the stomata closed. What happens? This we are studying the easiest mechanism why the opening and closing of stomata is taking place. During daytime, endoosmosis takes place. Water enters inside, guard cells become swell. Okay, swelling takes place or swollen. Guard cells, okay, because of endoosmosis, they get swollen, they become turgid. Pressure, this outer wall becomes stretched. Pressure get created on inner wall also, and inner wall also get pulled apart from each other, and stomata opens during daytime. While in nighttime, exosmosis takes place, means guard cells now gives water return to subsidiary cells. Okay, because of this, the guard cells becomes flaccid. Because of this flaccidity, there is a wall, inner wall of guard cells come close to each other and stomata get closed during night. So this is the easiest mechanism why and how the opening and closing of stomata takes. Today, see students, you know, simple mechanism you know. Why there is opening and closing of stomata, that you know, simple mechanism. But according to Stibbard, this is the name of the scientist. According to Stibbard, this particular pattern for some reason is there for opening and closing of stomata. To that reason, to that mechanism, he named it as starch-sugar interconversion theory. In this theory, in this starch-sugar interconversion theory, Stewart, in the year 1964, he had explained the reason why there is opening and closing of stomata. Okay, so now let's study what is starch-sugar interconversion theory. Now, according to this theory, what Stewart had suggested, during daytime, you all know, during daytime, stomata open. So, what is the reason behind opening of stomata? According to him, during daytime, the starch, which is accumulated during night, starch is nothing but it is food only. Starch is getting converted into sugar by the enzyme phosphoramidase. What? Here, according to Stewart, during daytime, starch, which is accumulated during night, it is getting converted into sugar because of the presence of enzyme phosphoramidase. Okay, once the sugar is present in the guard cell. Suppose this is the guard cell, and now during daytime, starch gets converted into sugar by this enzyme phosphoryglase. As soon as there is a conversion of sugar, what happens? The osmotic potential increases. Means the guard cells need water. Osmosis, endosmosis should take place. Osmotic potential increases and it results into endosmosis. Means water molecule from the subsidiary cells, it takes entry inside the guard cells. And you know what happens when the guard cells receives water, naturally the guard cells swell. Guard cells swell means the outer lining get stretched. Because of this, the pressure get pulled or pressure get exerted on the inner wall, and the inner wall get pulled and the stomata gets open. Okay, so according to Steward, during daytime, starch which is accumulated during night inside the guard cells, with the help of enzyme phosphoryglase, this starch get converted into sugar. This sugar, as soon as there is a conversion of sugar, osmotic potential inside the guard cell increases. It needs osmosis. So, it receives water from the surrounding subsidiary cells. And you know what happens? After receiving this water, the guard cells swell. The outer wall, which is thin, will get stretched. And it exerts pressure on the inner wall. And as a result, inner wall also get pulled and the stomata gets open. Now, the reverse condition is there during night. During night, you know, stomata get closed. What exactly happened according to Steward? According to Steward, during night, the sugar. During day, sugar is present. As soon as night comes, this sugar gets converted into starch. Same enzyme is responsible. Enzyme phosphoryglase convert sugar into starch. As soon as starch is there, then osmotic potential decreases. It do not need water. So water loss or loss of water takes place from guard cell to the subsidiary cells. And you know what happens when the loss of water takes place, the guard cells become flaccid. They shrink and the inner wall come close to each other and it results into the closing of stomata. So here, according to Steward, I have explained you starch-sugar interconversion. During daytime, starch is getting converted into sugar. Water entry takes inside and the guard cells become turgid and they get open. During night, this same sugar get converted into starch with the help of enzyme phosphoryglase, and as starch is there, osmotic potential decreases and it loses water and the guard cells become flaccid, means they get closed.